Welcome to the Ingisund Piano Center and its inaugural gala event, three live-streamed concerts recorded in Arvika, Sweden, in the Great Hall of Karlstad University at the Ingisund School of Music.
The gala event will consist of three live-stream concerts entitled Within, Around and Beyond. This three-part series offers a journey through which we can explore the evolution of man in his individuality, his relation to the world, and his wonder for what might lie beyond. Within opens with the freshness of Mozart, where the luminous virtuosity of the motifs fuse with the beautiful simplicity of its lyricism. Rachmaninoff takes us through the discovery of all inner emotions and their extremes, the profusion of excitement, the first impact of heartache and anguish, to the feeling of serenity and joy. The extract from the partita is an invitation to look back at the past. The sanctity of Bach, one of the fundamental pillars of music itself, combined with Rachmaninoff's ingenuous romanticism, evokes the awareness of adulthood and growth. Inspired by the story of Orpheus and Eurydice, Gluck and Sgambati's melody confronts us directly to the vulnerability of humanity and its weaknesses. Orpheus, after going to the depths of hell to bring back his beloved Eurydice, cannot resist to look at her, thus breaking the only rule imposed upon him and losing her forever. De Falla's Danza Ritual del Fuego symbolizes the shock of man with the elements and the unknown, pushing him to seek new adventures.
Thank you. and trying to be in the moment where, you know, there's just things that just come up in your life. But I guess that's the adventure of our profession. You know, sometimes you're in the moment, sometimes you're not. And sometimes when you're not in the moment, you know, there can be things that you discover about yourself. And that can be very interesting. And I think that to breathe in life is something that I need. Also in my music. I'm quite spontaneous. And I would also say that in music, especially in performance, I don't really like to plan how things go. Because I think that's what makes it fun. But at the same time, you know, that may annoy some people. Or it might come off as, you know, not the most cultured ever. But, you know, music is kind of, for me, it's just an expression of myself. And so, do I care about what people think? My brain does not. My heart kind of does. I guess I would say that I'm both excited but also afraid of uncertainty. Well, I would say, you know, I think it is kind of uncertainty about just how things will go and how I will feel from them. More so how I will react to certain things, because I would say I'm quite a intuitive and emotional kind of person. And, you know, of course, I understand that there are many things in life which we cannot control. I think that by myself, probably not, but I'm very, very grateful for all the support that I have from my friends. And I think together with a community of people, it will be okay.
I speak Danish, of course, and Polish was my first language. I've learned English and German in school. And then my first piano teacher, she was Russian. I didn't understand anything in the beginning, but since my mother is Polish, she understood Russian because they had it in school. So she was translating a bit in the beginning, and then I automatically got better and better and understood. And now also living in Sweden, I learned to speak Swedish. All the different languages have different tone colors, and yeah, just that is already a lot. And in music, you have to do a lot of different colors, and yeah, it's like a language in itself, music, and this language is so universal. So everyone, it speaks just to your heart. I try to connect with the music somehow. And also it's easier when you have played, for example, a piece that you know better, then it somehow triggers some different emotions in what you feel. But even if it's an unknown piece, I try to listen for different sounds and colors, also rhythm and mood. So there are plenty of factors that take place. Well, I definitely see myself continuing the path I'm doing right now. So trying to search for my own personality on stage and just learn from others. And I would like to just go and share my music with the audience again, whenever then that's going to be possible now during this pandemic. But yeah, it's a never ending process, really. I would like to be a pianist that has something to express on stage, that it's always alive, the music, and it's never boring. There's something in the touch and in the sound that just captivates the audience. And this, I think, is the most beautiful thing, that when you feel this tension between the performer and the audience, that they are really listening and you are listening yourself to what is happening in the room and the atmosphere. Intimacy in the performance that flows naturally. And it doesn't necessarily have to be something crazy, but just that there is always this red thread through your lines and phrases. This is what I would like to master in the end.
Yeah, the spotlight actually makes me uncomfortable. And that's one of the things actually I'm learning from my profession. And that's one of the things that this profession makes me to learn. Because being in the spotlight, it's almost like being naked in a way. That you have, there's nothing that can hide you. You can just not hide, you know, anyhow. And this requires a lot of self-discipline, a lot of self-knowing. And I think it's a very good thing to learn. Also, what I learned during the pandemics, that it's so important to be able to be with your own self. Because when you're lonely, you have to be the best friend for yourself. And this is a great ability to learn, I think, a great skill to learn. During pandemics, I've been actually learning to listen to my own necessities, my actual necessities, not the necessities that are coming from outside, from the outside world or whatever, from the people, you know, like teachers or people who say, tell me to do things. But I've been really learning to do things how I want. This is a wonderful, really, it's an amazing feeling when you lose your own self when you're playing, when you're only serving the music and you're going with the flow of the music. And music is something so much greater than us, than our own selves. And this is an amazing escape. I think that studying philosophy made me a little bit more grounded to the earth. Because music is very passionate always. It's about emotions, about passion. But philosophy is something that brings you really more maybe towards the earth. That makes you think, makes you maybe stop a lot of things that you've been doing just because you're doing them already. And yeah, it's a great thing just to stop sometimes and think.
Thank you. I think I'm a very simple person. Like, people think I'm much more complicated and perhaps sophisticated than I am. Like, I like very simple pleasures. I think very simply, and I have a very straightforward way of living, I think, that most people don't expect. I think they assume that there's always a lot going on in my brain, which is not necessarily the case. Like, I am actually just very simple. I don't think that because I have been doing many things in my life, and spotlight or not spotlight, that it means that I have to be complicated or seek complication in life. I'm discovering a lot of things about myself during this, especially during this pandemic, because I have time to think sometimes. Because before the pandemic, I'm obsessed with doing. And it's just like, I want to know better for myself why I do what I do, why I enjoy what I do, and what drives me to do what I do. And it's still in progress, but I think this is a very healthy process. I live very much in the moment, and I place huge emphasis on enjoyment of what I do. And so I don't think so much about the future. I think in previous years, like in interviews or whatever, I would always say that I'm very project-based. And like, if there are no projects, I don't practice. But in my entire life up to now, that has worked very well because there are always projects. And so now I find, like, for example, like in the beginning of the year, I wanted to learn the Chopin Preludes. For the first time in my life, I'm learning something because I find them beautiful, which is very striking considering that I've been playing the piano for 22 years. This is the first time I'm actually learning something because I just wanted to admire and get to know its beauty. Mm-hmm. And it was a bit of a striking realization for myself. I love performing, and I love the experience of performing, but I would like to find out clearer why that is. But I enjoy the experience of sharing. I enjoy the energy of, like, you know, the music, the spirituality, and the love that is shared in the concert hall. But why exactly that is, I don't know. And there's a sort of high you get from performing, right?
Thank you.
As you can see from the background, it's quite a change from my home. It's a metropolitan city. I'm used to being very, very compact place. And now being in Sweden, in Arvika, is such a change for me. Such a change may be reflected in my musical journey as well. I think in my 20s, I have gone through different phases of musical search. For example, first, you understood music, you try to understand music further, deeper, and you try to apply music in a different society. And now I'm in another phase. I'm in a phase where I try to find a different truth. Not different truth, so to say, but perhaps a deeper truth that I never knew before. And I think that's one of the purposes that I'm in Arvika now. To share with you, one of the transformation I have had in the last few months were that I never knew that I actually did not understood myself enough. I never knew that I perhaps deep down I could have discovered a deeper self, but not until a very rigorous routine of working in such a silent and focused environment where I can find a part of myself that is even more further and deeper, digging deeper than I thought. Now I'm on a train that I do not know where is the next train stop. I used to know. I used to have a script. That's the script. Hong Kong was my script. It's still my script. It's part of what I do. But now I truly embrace myself in an unexpected journey. I go ahead in this train ride where I don't know where I arrive at, but I know one thing, is that I'll keep searching and digging deeper and become a more complete pianist, so to say. I do want to bring something that is transcendental to my audiences, to the listeners. You know what? Actually, in a way, through me, but also through the music. I believe that we have to be selfless and selfish at the same time with music. Personally, I find that only when I have a strong devotion and immersion with the music, where my music, not my music, the music that I play, can have a certain perception and personal touch that reaches the most people. Also, I'm a pianist, I'm a performer. It's interesting to note that I'm not a composer. I'm not even an improviser, which means I play music that some other human beings composed last year or a few hundred years ago. And there's a certain devotion and humility to that because it's those music somehow have become a collective global cultural heritage. And I think all pianists in the world these days are part of this wheel of heritage. I think I would definitely say Schumann's Fantasy. It's a piece that touches my heart the most. It's the piece that I perhaps spent the most time with. And interestingly, I've played it for perhaps over 10 years. It has evolved within me through times. And that's something interesting about music as well. Music is our friend. It's our personal friend. It's a difficult relationship, but I think at one point, we do have to find our comfortability with this friend of ours. A lot of classical musicians perhaps do not, some of them perhaps do not realize, but we do have a role in this world, in this society as a whole. I think we don't only provide something that is pleasure or leisurely. I think it is through this personal struggle, striving, and deep devotion with this art that we discover something very unspoken about our mankind, about our humanity. And through this vocation of sharing music, that is truly the meaning of why do classical musicians still exist or still play music to the audiences of our time and perhaps the audiences of the future. So this is my little sharing about my musical thoughts.
we would like to especially thank the chairman of our advisory board, Alf Bjørnseth. Without his generous support, along with our main sponsors, the Vestre Värmland Sparbank and Andersvall Beer Foundation, none of this would be possible. Thank you for making our dream a reality. We invite you to visit our website to read the impressive biographies of all our pianists and to learn more about the Ingesund Piano Center and its activities. Thank you for being here, and we hope you enjoy the concerts.